Good evening, everyone. Hope you guys enjoyed the little buffet that we had going on. It's pretty good. As some of you may know, I prepared a speech for today a while ago that had me audition. But the more I rehearsed it, the more I realized that it was a little bit disingenuous to myself. And I wanted to speak from the heart and really elaborate more on what's gotten me here and moreover what's gotten us all here, right? So I want to share a little experience with you. In elementary school, I love to wear suits. I mean, as you can see, I'm a big suit guy. To wake up on the first day of school and put on this beautiful black three-piece suit that my parents had worked tirelessly to buy for me. So there I am. I put on my, you know, shirt, my tie, and my shoes, and I take the school bus to Lomita Magnet Elementary School. And I walk onto the school with pride. And instead of being met with that same acceptance and praise that I was expecting for putting so much effort into my outfit, I was met with smart remarks like, why are you wearing that? And I was actually given the nickname Nancy Pants by some. Fast forward to middle school. I wore a similar suit for the interview that we had for this beautiful school of ours. And like many of us, or some of us here, we actually had our PSAT day on the same day as our interview. And I had to sit through the entire test again with the three-piece suit. And again, instead of being met with that same acceptance and praise, you know, that you would expect, I was again met with disdain. That was the day I learned that it wasn't about them. I have a quote here. It says, "It's not the critic who counts, nor the man who points out how the strong man stumbles. The credit belongs to the man in the arena, whose face is marred by sweat and blood, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at best, in the end, knows the triumph of high achievement, and who at worst, at least, fails while daring greatly." 26th President Theodore Roosevelt discovered this exact same lesson that I did back when he was campaigning through Europe. He stopped in Paris to give a speech. He was addressing all the cynics of the world who criticized the people who were trying to make the world a better place. And even in 1910, he understood that the criticisms of others should not come in between yourself and your goals. Speaking of goals, none of us would be achieving the goal of graduation with our esteemed teachers. So can we give them a round of applause real quick? You see, not only do we see them almost every day, but they're an integral part of our lives. I'd like to give a special thanks to the teachers, Mr. Lamb and Ms. Cole. Forget the memories that we made, especially with those teachers. I'm sure y'all remember the dodgeball tournament back in ninth grade. Mr. Lamb was goated. And then we have the reenactments of Shakespeare recently in English class with Ms. Cole. These teachers are showing us what it's like to be more than faculty, but to be family. If the phrase "No Child Left Behind" was a person, it would without a doubt be these two teachers. But what I really want you guys to take away from this is, it's not necessarily about the way that you dress or about the way that the world may try to bring you down, criticize you, and just beat down on you. It's about being ready for the life ahead of you. One that will be filled with critics and with naysayers. So don't be afraid to wear that suit and stand out from the rest. After all, we are all made to stand out from the rest. We are all destined for greatness. Thank you, everyone.